Let's now look into an example where the client sends Secure Access 1 and unlocks the ECU for Secure Access. Firstly, the client sends 2701 seed request and the server responds 670136. In the last video, we had a look into the overview of Secure Access Service, Service 27. Let's now dive into details of Secure Access Service. To start with, let's look into the request message definition of the seed request and send key service together. In the request message definition for seed request, we have Secure Access Request SID mapped to value 27. And in case of request message definition for send key request, we also have the Secure Access Request SID mapped to value 27. Next, for request seed, we have the subfunction mapped to Secure Access type equal to request seed. And for send key request, we have the subfunction mapped to Secure Access type equal to send key. The subfunction parameter Secure Access type indicates to the server different steps in progress for this service, the level of security the client wants to access, and the format of seed and key. If a server supports different levels of security, then each level shall be identified by the request seed value, which has a fixed relationship with the send key value. The request seed subfunction value shall always be an odd number, and the corresponding send key subfunction parameter value for the same security level shall be request seed subfunction parameter value plus 1. For example, if the request seed is 1, then the send key would map to value 2. And if the request seed is of value 3, then the send key would map to value 4. Let's now look into different classification of subfunction values. Value 0, 43 to 5E, and 7F. These values are ISO SAE reserved for future. Then value 1, 3, 5, from 7 to 41. These values are meant for request seed with different levels of security defined by vehicle manufacturer. Value 2, 4, 6, from 8 to 42. These values are meant for send key with different levels of security defined by the vehicle manufacturer. Value 5F maps to request seed with different levels of security defined for end-of-line activation of onboard pyrotechnic device as defined in ISO 26021-2. Value 60 maps to send key with different levels of security defined for end-of-line activation of onboard pyrotechnic device as defined in ISO 26021-2. The value range from 61 to 7E is reserved for system supplier specific use cases. Now let's jump to next parameter of the service. In case of request seed, we have security access data record, which is an optional user data which can be transmitted to the server when requesting the seed information. And for send key, we have security key, which is the value generated by the security algorithm corresponding to a specific seed value received from request seed service. Let's now have a look into generic positive response format for security access service. Firstly, we have the Secure Access Response SID, which maps to 67. Then we have the subfunction, which maps to the request subfunction value of secure access type. And lastly, in case of secure access type equal to request seed, we have the security seed parameter present in the response. Let's now have a look into the negative response code applicable to security access. Firstly, we have NRC12, subfunction not supported. This NRC is sent if the subfunction parameter is not supported. Then we have NRC13, incorrect message length or invalid format. This NRC is sent if the length of the message is wrong. Then we have NRC22, condition not correct. This NRC is sent if the criteria for the requested security access are not met. NRC24, request sequence error. This NRC is sent if the send key subfunction is received without first receiving a request seed message. NRC31, request out of range. This NRC is sent if the user optional security access data record contains invalid data. NRC35, invalid key. This NRC is sent if an expected send key subfunction value is received and the value of the key does not match the server's internally stored or calculated key. NRC36, exceed number of attempts. This NRC is sent if the delay timer is active because of exceeded number of allowed false access attempts. NRC37, required time delay not expired. This NRC is sent if the delay timer is active and a request is transmitted which cannot be accepted currently. Let's now look into an example where the client sends secure access 1 and unlocks the ECU for secure access. Firstly, the client sends 2701 seed request and the server responds 6701 3658. Here, 3658 are the seed values. Client would then compute the key based on the seed 3658 and then send the key request 2702C9A9. Server shall compare the key with its existing or computed key and provide the access and respond with 6702. With this, we had a detailed look into the Secure Access 27 service in this session. In upcoming session, we'll have a look into the Communication Control 28 service. Thank you.